We came down to this site and there were literally bones falling out of the hills all over the place. Almost everywhere we go, we can excavate bones of all kinds of different animals. Predatory theropod dinosaurs, long-necked herbivorous dinosaurs, jaws and teeth of small mammals and their relatives, other extinct groups of fossil reptiles. In South Africa, in the late Triassic, almost everything we found is new. In fact, we haven't found anything that was previously known before. Right now, I'm on an expedition to South Africa, and we're looking for dinosaurs and the other animals that lived alongside them more than 200 million years ago in the late Triassic. I've been working here for the last 5 years with my collaborator, Jonah Schwanier, from the Evolutionary Studies Institute of Wits University.
We are here in the village of Qhemegha, in the Eastern Cape province of South Africa, right on the border of the Orange River, where it dumps out of the highlands of Lesotho, and we're sitting actually on rocks that were laid down about 200 million years ago. And we can see fossils actually coming out of the ground.
This year is my first opportunity to do field work in Africa. It's a new place to me, and it's basically it's a dinosaur site. I work on fossil mammals. Finding a small mammal is quite different. The age of the rock that we're looking at, that's about the time mammal originated. And that sediments will likely contain the fossils that will be the first mammals.
We were originally called to work here by the local community, and they've been hugely supportive of what we're doing.
There's a core group of what they call community pioneers here, and probably the chief among these community pioneers is a man named Skinyane Khalane. He goes by Ski. So Ski was present when the first fossils were found, and he recognized them as ancient animals.
Sawafumana ngo 2015. Umfana obizwa ukuba nguDumangwe Qhemegha. Nguye owaba ngumuntu oqala ukufumana lamathambo azozinqalela. Yayinto enhle ebandiyifumana egqibeleni lento, saphila. Jonah came with a group and prospect the whole area, then they agreed that it was a rich in fossil. That was the first time when we know that this was a dino grave site.
So we don't know why there are so many bones here, but we sure know there are a lot of fossils.
We spend a lot of time on the landscape, really just walking with our heads hunched over, looking at the ground. We're lucky here in Qhemegha because there's just so many bones that we quite often find something. In fact, every day we find a new fossil.
Sometimes all we find is the stuff on the surface, but oftentimes we find that there are bones going into the rock. So in these cases, we can spend weeks and months carefully excavating, digging a quarry. The goal of the quarry is to dig around those bones and make field jackets out of plaster and burlap that protect the bones so we can transport them back to the prep lab, and then there carefully in a controlled conditions excavate the bones from the rock.
All the fossils here tell us a bigger picture, which is change in Earth ecosystem over the time. In the Triassic, all of Earth's continents are glued together into a single giant supercontinent, which we call Pangaea. They show ecosystems where dinosaurs aren't the dominant animals. In fact, it's mainly things that are related to crocs. As the Earth's tectonics change into the Jurassic, and the first thing that happens is the Atlantic Ocean begins to form. There's actually a rift between North and South America and Europe and Africa. There's a huge amount of lava that pours out on Earth's surface. And this lava releases greenhouse gases, and it also changes the chemistry of the ocean. The animals that are on land are facing shifts in global temperature or rapid fluctuations and maybe seasonal rainfall, and they can't adapt and they go extinct. And suddenly there's a shift, and all of a sudden everything we find is a dinosaur, and it's very rare to find these croc-line animals.
We don't know exactly why dinosaurs survived when other things became extinct, but it caused a major change in the biosphere that we're interested in studying as paleontologists. So by studying the fossils here, we hope to get a much more clear picture of the end Triassic mass extinction event because this area preserves an almost continuous sequence of rocks that starts in the latest Triassic and ends in the early Jurassic, so spanning this mass extinction event. And by getting fossils from this area, we'll get a really clear understanding of what species were around just before the event and who went extinct during the event. So there were several different types of dinosaurs living on the landscape in the late Triassic here. So we've got sauropodomorphs. The sauropodomorphs are their early cow-sized relatives of the sauropod dinosaurs. There were also predatory theropod dinosaurs. They're early in the history of the group. And strangely, although we knew they were present in South Africa, we didn't find them in a lot of other places. On top of that, we have other groups, like these animals called pseudosuchians, which are big fossil reptiles that are quite closely related to crocs. And in one of our quarries, we found this amazing 5-meter-long pseudosuchian predator. You can imagine this thing as being a bit like a small T-Rex, but it walks on all fours. It's the biggest predator so far in the ecosystem. We're pretty sure it would have been eating the dinosaurs. And we also have small animals that includes early relatives of mammals.
For many years, we know that South Africa have so many of those beautifully preserved specimens of mammal-like reptiles, but it's kind of one step short of the origin of mammal. This time, we find one lower jaw. It's very small. And in the field, when I saw that specimen, to me at least, I think that's the most important discovery and at that moment and that trip. I know that from my knowledge, this is something very close to mammal. It's not quite a mammal yet, but that's what we're looking for. Before this, we don't know there's such animal exist, but now we have that clue.
The fossils we've collected at Qhemegha are reposited at Wits University for now. There's a lot of community support to build either a museum or an interpretive center here in Qhemegha, and the local people and interested tourists and other members of the South African and sort of global paleo community could come here and look at them.
This is a world-class thing. We would like to see this museum in a world-class setting.
The materials become really important in training South African students in paleontology with genuinely new, exciting material that's telling us a great deal about the evolutionary history of life on Earth. Paleontologists could work in this area for many decades to come, still continuing to make new discoveries.